The new mission is to go to the loop current and see if there is any surface oil, but also subsurface oil. This is a unique spill in that it happened so deep and is having dispersants added to it. So there's a possibility that larger parts of the loop current can have oil within them. And by larger parts, I mean deeper parts. So we're all used to seeing the surface spills. Whenever there's an oil spill, we typically see it at the surface, but there are things you can't see beneath the surface in this case, and that's what we're looking for. Most of what we're using is straightforward bottle samples that are collected at a controlled depth. We anticipated the incorporation of the spill into the loop current and saw that our models were predicting that it would happen very quickly or very soon, and a concern for an invisible deep water conveyance of oil that people just weren't really aware was happening. That's what we want to go out and check with this cruise. Yes, that's a referred to as a rosette, but the bottles arranged around it can be tripped electronically, so that entire apparatus is raised and lowered through the water and can collect water samples at any point where we need them. And the whole time it's in the water, it's collecting information on a variety of different things.
This is actually my first overnight cruise, so I'm hoping to learn a lot. Doing overnight research, we're going out to the oil slick to see kind of the effects, and that's just really kind of overwhelmed with the whole situation. I actually have a final this morning that I'm going to be administered on the boat because I'm going out.
We're headed pretty much due west, and then we're going to, if and when we see oil, we're going to be zigzagging around in that area and taking measurements where and if we see anything. It's scary. It's scary. The research on the effect that crude oil, this Sweet Louisiana crude, would have on corals especially, it hasn't been done that thoroughly, but it's scary to have that much of a pollutant out in the water right around these really fragile ecosystems.
Well, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be looking at the distribution of marine mammals out in the vicinity of the slick. Obviously, the oil is potentially going to have a great impact on the marine mammals of the Gulf of Mexico. And so far, no one's done a survey of where the marine mammals are in the vicinity of the slick. Yeah, I study dolphin acoustics and distribution, and it's important to get some baseline measurements of what the dolphin population is doing out there before the slick impacts the area more. Oh, I've worked with a lot of stranded animals before, but no, something of this gravity, I haven't experienced anything like it, so I can't say I'm prepared for anything.